Do you remember the time when those museum statues came to life? Well, they're back, and with many more adversaries and friends than ever before. In the sequel to Ninth Museum, Battle of the Smithsonian, directed by Sean Levy and starring Ben Stiller. For a lot of families, the first Night at the Museum movie really captured the magic of seeing lifeless figures that families often visit museums come to life and partake in a rip-roaring adventure with a supporting cast including comedic talent like Owen Wilson as Jedi, the funny miniature cowboy. The sequel, on the other hand, more or less does the same thing, and infuses more of a blockbuster-esque punch into it than the first one did. This film is bigger and grander in scale, as some time has passed since the first adventure, and Larry Daly, Ben Stiller, the Squid's Night Guard job from the first film, who started the technology company Larry Devices, found great success. However, he's not truly content, as when he sees that his favorite friends, the statues from the museum in the first movie, are about to be shipped off to the Smithsonian Institution and won't be accompanied by the life-giving tablet, he jumps into action. Larry debated his action at first, but after realizing that this was something he must do, he does everything he can to ensure his friend's safety. However, he runs into trouble, though, when the tablet arrives at the Smithsonian Institution and gives life to a whole other host of statues, including some villainous threats, the most prominent of them all being Ivan the Terrible, who wishes to conquer all. In order to save his friends, Larry must team up with the statue come to life, Amelia Earhart, Amy Adams, and stop Ivan the Terrible from conquering. The cast is built with some impressive talent. There's Ben Stiller, who returns to portray Larry Daly and effectively shows the journey that his character is going down, as he steps down from success to do something to make a difference. Amy Adams does a wonderful job portraying the wonderfully spunky Amelia Earhart, as she is the light in this movie for some audience-going parents who may find the movie absurdly ridiculous. The cast is well rounded off, with returning Owen Wilson, who does a great job bringing to life Jedediah, a cowboy who, for all intents and purposes, is glad to be alive, and Robin Williams as Teddy Roosevelt, who is in the first film and captures a powerful leader and mentor figure to the hero of the story, Larry Daly. The villain, Ivan the Terrible, played by Christopher Guest, is surprisingly entertaining as he brings an intensity of malevolence to the screen while at the same time presenting enormous defects, such as his stuttering. The cast delivers a great experience for families as they entertain and bring to life the characters they are portraying at a top caliber level. Character development in the story is lacking. Larry Daly does go from being on the ring of success to returning to night guard duty, but all the audience is ever really given is throwing Larry back into an adventure to change his mind about what makes him happy. Amelia Earhart, while being a great foil to Larry, is primarily a static character in the film, as she doesn't really develop to the point where you really believe in the relationship between her and Larry presented here. The primary objective of this film obviously isn't to infuse rich characters, but tell an entertaining story that will churn out money. So what do all these conjectures really say or mean? Is this a worthwhile addition to family entertainment? What does this film have to say about how we view historical figures? I believe this film is worth a family's time, especially for those families that have parents that want to view a film with their kids that they will be entertained by too. The story brings historical figures to life literally through the magical tablet, and in doing so, if someone reflectively looks back at this concept, they may see that this is the writer's way of informing the audience that history is rich and full of interesting characters and should be respected. Overall, I think Ninth Museum, Battle of the Smithsonian is a fun and action-packed entertaining family film, which delivers thrills but lacks in character development. I'm assigning this film a score of 7 out of 10.